Hello and welcome to a new R programming webcast. Today we will see how easy it is to do geocoding using the R programming language, meaning how to get the latitude and longitude of any location or place you may have in your own dataset. So we will see how to connect R to 13 different geocoding API services such as Google Maps, Bing, Mapbox, ArcGIS, OpenStreetMap, for example. And we will see also how to visualize these locations on an interactive map. Finally, we will compare how these different geocoding services perform by comparing them on an interactive map using our own little dataset, which will be the locations where James Bond has been in the different movies on the franchise. And if you want to follow along on your own computer this tutorial, you can join my newsletter on felixanalytics.com. And once you subscribe, you will receive an automatic email from me with the URL of my GitHub account, where you can access all the code of this tutorial as well as my previous tutorials. That being said, let's do some geocoding opening RStudio.
Right, so the first thing we want to do, as always, is to install the necessary R packages if they're not installed, and we will attach them. So we will load the tidyverse, RVS to do some web scrapping, use this to get access to some utilities for secrets. We will see how to use it a bit later. The tidy geocoder R package, which is a great R package I want to present to you today to access these different geocoding API services, and leaflet to create interactive maps. Let's begin by creating our little dataset by scrapping a Wikipedia page to get all the locations where James Bond has been in the different movies. So here is a URL with an old ID over here, allows us to have exactly the same Wikipedia version, so we work on the same HTML page. So if I open this URL, we will see here a table with the location in the story on the actual location where James Bond has been in the movie for each movie. So here is the first movie, Dr. No, for 1962, with the coordinates on the country or region depicted. And we have that for each movie until the last ones. So to get the table using the HTML element from the average package, you can just run this little code. And if we run this table in the R console over here, and we see we indeed have the data that we just saw on Wikipedia. Now that we have our table, we want to tidy it, so to clean it in a tidy way, which is the principle that the tidyverse is following. And this tidy principle is basically that each variable must have its own column, each observation have its own row, and each value has its own cell. So here, this little code over here will do some cleaning, creating the movie variable that is not in a tidy way here, as you can see it, and do some other data cleaning on the countries. So let's run this code. On this other chunk of code, we'll extract the latitude and longitude from the coordinates column over here and do some extra cleaning. So now we have our table that is tidy. We have six columns or variables with 237 rows. Let me show you more in detail how the data looks like. So here we have the location in the story, the actual location, the latitude, the longitude, the region or the region did, and this movie variable that just created following the tidy principles. And this data structure is very important to have for your own dataset, because the tidy geocoder R package that we will use is working only if your data is tidy, so you can use the function of this R package. Before connecting R to one of these different geocoding API services, I will have to get the keys for some of them. Some services don't require an API key, for example, the OpenStreetMap service or ArcGIS. But if you want to use Google Map, Bing, or Mapbox, for example, you will need to create an account in these specific websites and get your own key. The function we will use recognizes by default the keys if you put them in the R environment file. So you can use this function, edit R environment over here, and this will automatically open a .R environment file for you. So let's run this. And in this .environment file, you will have to add this specific specific keys following the same namings over here. So this is for Mapbox, for Google Maps, and for Bing. And these keys will be automatically taken into account when you run the function from the tidy geocoders R package. Here I put the reference for the services. So let's have a look at it. So here you have the overview of the tidy geocoder function with the locations. And if we scroll down now, we can see the different environment variables we should have and name for each of these services. You can use also this function in the R console to get this information. Right, another point is that if you use this .r environ that I recommend you to use, you may want to put this file in your .gitignore file so you don't leak or share by mistake your own key secret tokens if you use Git. Once your .environ file is ready, you will have to restart R so R can take into account these new environment variables. So let's do this right now. So we go into session and restart R. And now, as you can see, our global environment is empty. So we will have to rerun all our previous code to be ready again. Now let's see how to get the latitude or longitude using any of these APR services from our little dataset over here. So the first thing is that I do is to create a new variable using the mutate function from dplyr, where I link together the location and the country to help the service API to find it. And now using the pipe, we will add the geocode function from this tidy geocoder R package, put the address name of column over here, and then we will choose the method here. As a first example, we will use the argkeys method, which doesn't require an API key, so you don't need to create an account. You can just run this code over here and it should work on your own computer. So let's run this. And now we will run this API on these 223 addresses in the argkeys API servers. And as you can see here, it will take us around 1 minute. Right, it took 2 minutes to perform this call. So now if we open our new R object, we will see that we will have these two new columns, new variables, lat and long, with the result of argis. The latitude and longitude columns over here were the one we scrapped. So by default, and they will call the lat and long. So if you want to use another service, what you just do is change the methods. For example, if you want to use OpenStreetMap, which also doesn't require a specific account on API key, you can write OSM and run this code, and you will also get the result, but this time from the OpenStreetMap API. If you want to use Google Maps API, you write Google over here, and this requires to have an account on a specific key. We will do that a bit later. Compare also the different geoservices in this specific dataset, but first I want to visualize the different locations on an interactive map. To do that, we will use leaflet. Be sure to save also the data so you don't have to wait 2 minutes again. And now this little code over here will create an interactive map. I want to visualize on them by movies, so I get the unique movies. I create a little pop-up for each point, and this is the code to create the leaflet with different layers. So let's run all this. And now we see our interactive map, and if we click in one location, we have the pop-up that we created over here, and this allows us to select the location by move. So let's have a look at some of them. We see indeed that it's Brazil, it's Yugoslavia here, so this didn't work at all. This is a Greek-Albanian border, so didn't work well. So we'll see here Argis doesn't performing a very good job on our dataset. So let's try other geocoding services like Google and Bing and see how they perform. Just before doing that, also I give you here how the code to do reverse geocoding. So if you want to get the address from the latitude and longitude from our dataset, you can do that. So if you remember, we have also in the table the latitude and longitude for some specific location for the James Bond movies. And if you run this code, the argkeys API will try to give you an address for this longitude and latitude locations. So if you run this code again, and then I just took the 21st rows to make it faster, we would get the different addresses. So if I open this object over here, we will see at the end the address from our keys service. Sometimes it works well, sometimes I guess it doesn't work so well. So feel free to experiment this on your own code. Right, now let's compare different geocoding services. On to make it a bit faster, I decided to select just a list of a few last movies from the James Bond franchise. Here I will remove the existing latitude and longitude from the table. I will take only the list of the movies that I selected over here. Again, I will create a new column that join or past the location, the address, on the country or the region in which this address is. And now we will use this geomcode_combine function from the tidy geocoder package. And we can here, using the queries argument, put a list of the different methods. So here I selected OpenStreetMap, ArcGIS, Mapbox, Bing, and Google Maps. On the global parameters argument over here, within the list allows us to choose the column or variable in which we will try to get the location. So here it's called location in story country. Note also that the cascade argument should be false if you want to get all the result of all the different methods. If you don't, you will get just run result normally for each of the addresses or location from your column over here. So let's run all this and see the results. Right, so this is the result. As you can see, OpenStreetMap, it took 37 seconds to get the 36 geolocalization. ArcGIS took only 17 seconds. And for the Mapbox being on Google, it only took 4 seconds, 6 seconds, and 4 seconds. These are the services you have to create a key. And these two ones over here are free to use without any key. Right, let's have a first look at how many queries worked by service. Some of them failed, didn't. So ArcGIS gave 37 results, as well as Bing, Google, Mapbox 36, and OpenStreetMap only 28 results, meaning some of them are missing values, which sometimes can be a good thing because in this James Bond addresses, we have imaginary locations, which is quite unusual. So let's see how it performs. So once again, we want to create an interactive map using leaflet, but this time by visualizing them on comparing the different services. So here I create color variable and give for each service a different color based on the blue palette set one over here. So if I run this code and I click on zoom, we will see we have the different results with some services giving unique results. Once again, we will not have exactly the same location because I selected only a portion of all the movies just for this test, but we will see we have superposition for some services. So OpenStreetMap give this position while Quantum of Solace, these two are supposed to be the same location, but each API geocoding service will give a different result. Looks like Google is better on this one. And we have ArcGIS putting Siena over here, while Mapbox put it over here. So it's quite close, right? Bing and Google. So looks like they perform a bit better. So we have superposition for some services. For example, here, Madagascar, Mapbox didn't catch it well. It's not very efficient to do that manually. So I wrote some codes to check and compare the distances between two geocoding services using the SF package. So first, I replace the missing values by zero because the STAS_SF function from the SF package doesn't like it. So I will not go into detail about how to use the SF package. This is not really the purpose of this video, but I can make another video about this. If you find it interesting, just let me know in the comments below. And here is the code using the ST_distance function to compare the location, the different points between ArcGIS and OSM, which is OpenStreetMap. So if I run this over here, and then we will create a new table with the distance over here. and view it like this. So here we see that the two services are located quite at the same place, the St. Peter Squares in Vatican City at around 8 meters of distance. So they perform quite well. They agreed both on this point. But in some other areas, like the Kuril Island, Nambutu Embassy, Montenegro, or Atlantic Ocean Road over here, in a way, the two services didn't find the same locations. This could be some ideas for you to double check the results. I thought it would be useful for you to have some ideas about how you can also use R to double check the result of the geocoding services you're using. Well, I hope this tutorial was useful. If it was, feel free to like or even subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you want to get the code, you can just go on my website, felixanalytics.com, and I see you in another video. Take care. Bye-bye.